Hello friends, this is Ricky from Vacant Wallet. In this video, we'll resolve the issue related to Canon 250D firmware update. Switch on the camera and then obviously dial will be in on program A mode, and then go to menu, function settings, fifth tab, and then you will see the firmware, which is version 1.0.0. But if you go to scene auto select mode, then you would not find the firmware option in fifth tab, which is, I don't know what is it. So you have to be in program or program A mode, and then function settings and see firmware version. It should be there. It would come in handy later on. Then format card as shown here. Okay, fine. After formatting the card, I just have to switch off the camera and then take out the memory card. Make sure your battery is fully charged before you perform the process of firmware upgradation. And then try not to insert your SD card in internal memory card slot of your laptop or PC. Obviously PCs don't have internal SD card slot, but laptops have. Try to put it in external SD card slot, like I have Digitech here. I got it in 250 bucks, so you can get easily in the market. Then go to Google and type Canon 250D firmware update. You can also check the link in description, I'll provide that. And then just click on the first link as I have clicked here, and then obviously download your software. If you have a camera, then obviously you are smart enough to know where to download the firmware update, but still I am showing you this. The main issue with me is that I was unable to perform my firmware update because of some errors. I don't know, but I knew that later and I'm sharing it with you. And extract these files, you have to copy this FIR file, that is firmware file, and then paste it into the SD card. So obviously if you are pasting it in an SD card which is inserted in an external card reader, it would obviously be good and operations would be performed without any hassle. So here you see I just paste and yeah, the file is there. Okay, now I have the firmware file in my SD card. Now I eject it safely. Now I'll show you, if I insert the memory card in internal card reader, what will happen. So here I have the file, I have inserted the memory card in internal card reader, and now I have the file here. So I'll rename the file something like, okay, which is in my PC obviously. So then I try to copy this file in my PC into the card reader, which is internal card reader. You will see it will show the disk is write protected. There is nothing with the disk, it is just with the card reader or the driver. So try not to do that. Always use an external card reader for your own ease. Okay, so now we'll switch to our camera and let's see what happens. Obviously we have the file here in our memory card. Okay, I'll eject it now, switch to our camera. So here I have the card, I performed it all the operations in external card reader but not the internal one. And now let's try to put this card in the camera. Make sure your battery is fully charged. Switch on the camera. and then put the dial in program AE mode, obviously menu, and then go to function settings, and then fifth tab, your firmware, okay, select, click on OK. Okay, fine. Now, yeah, it will verify your firmware file if it is legit or not, and obviously it would be legit as we have downloaded it from the official website. Now it will take some time to boot. Okay, here we have the file which we have copied, the firmware file. Okay, now click on update firmware. And one thing I want to tell you, that this video I made because I was using internal cards, so there was some issue with internal card reader. So then I got a new external card reader which helped me resolve the issue. So when performing a firmware update, always use an external card reader. This is Ricky from Vacant Wallet signing off.